Okay, welcome back. And welcome, Dawn and Stuart.
What's going on?
Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and... I believe, Will, your character Colin, was on the ship. So, I went ahead and put the Rodian lackey and the Aqualish thug in a room for confinement since we were reminded that they were still on board.
Okay. What ship is this, out of interest?
Say what?
What ship is this?
This is our ship, the Grey Star.
And what type of ship is it?
Oh, it's a Wayfarer. I want to go ahead and get things started. I want to go ahead and do the obligation. So we got a lot of obligation.
By the way, since we're just kind of doing admin stuff, how is obligation bought off? Is it roleplayed off or is it bought off with experience?
There's two parts. So, like, your main obligation is generally pretty hard to get off.
Yeah, I know there's, like, the 10 points we have to start with that you pretty much have to have off the
so
time.
So the bonus, like, the bonus one is done through XP, and they say, you know, you're doing the equivalent of 20,000 plus credits to buy it off.
Okay.
So it's kind of a long-term thing you need to constantly work.
I was just trying to figure out if it's if there was a roleplay aspect to it in Star Wars, or if it's just simply sinking experience points in it to get it to go away. I wasn't sure. That's what I was trying to figure out.
Okay.
So, Colin, it looks like it rolled on you today, so you take -2 strain, everyone else gets -1 strain.
Okay.
So that we can't recover for the game, because you're focused on one of your obligations.
And you're bitching about it, which distracts the rest of us.
Yeah, stop bitching about your obligation, we all gotta do stuff.
He doesn't need that to distract us.
Colin?
Yeah?
Colin, can you roll me a d4? Just go slash roll d4 and tell me... Thank you.
All right, so we can go ahead and do our Destiny dice now.
Thanks, Durin.
It's just one force dice we roll, right?
Yes.
There's actually a destiny on your character.
Oh, I don't even have to mess with the force dice pool. I can just click roll Destiny.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I thought I had to press up to have one of those.
Now, when you roll Destiny, it automatically goes
all
on.
Right. This is looking good.
Does Doran roll good? Oh, good. Oh, this is real good.
Two things I need to follow up with people. Not that it matters now, that Maz was kind of correct. He could have used his reload to offset his pistol for that one despair. And then the other part is I've been reading up on darkness. Full darkness is three black dice, and then if you can see in the dark, like a Keldorian, or you have night vision goggles, or the proper helmet, will remove two of those black dice.
That's going to be my first next thing that I buy, is something to see in the dark, because obviously we need it.
Hey, Dell, I went ahead and added his manually.
Okay, thanks.
We left off that Colin is in... the shower.
Debating on going into the shower with Maya.
He's in the bathroom, right?
But I
turned it Jeff, off. I just inadvertently clicked. Can you reset the pull? The pull should be 2.7. I accidentally moved it to 6.3.
No problem.
Okay, so, Colin, we've kind of already worked with... Sarad, and right now you're going to be the Wookiee until I can see your character sheet name. We already worked with the two new folks, so you're waiting outside. Do you open the door or not? And you're getting some strange looks from other PCs because you're sitting there in a towel.
I'm going to go into the bathroom, but not actually into the shower yet.
All right. So, You go into the bathroom. The door to the shower area, or I'm sorry, refresher is closed. And
Thorne's going to tap on his shoulder. And if you ever saw Jay and Silent Bob, that look he gave him with the raised eyebrows and shrugs his shoulder. And he's like, do you really think this is a good idea?
I just smile and I just nod, yeah.
Hey, I tried. And I'm just going to sit
back. I'm going to just kind of be chilling in there, brushing my teeth and just trying to be all smooth about being like, you good in there or you need a hand?
Then you hear,
just a minute.
What is Thornton doing? He just gave the look and walked away.
Yeah, I think I got some credentials I need to work on.
He's like, nope, I'm out of here.
Del, are you you just kind of doing...
Already left. I'm in the control room or...
Yeah, you're doing basic ship maintenance, checking out the ship. Okay. So, the refresher stops. She opens the door, sees you, and looks very startled.
And I'm not, like, pervy looking. I'm just chilling, brushing my teeth in there when I said that. So I'm not, like, trying to sneak a peek at her, which opens
no,
the door.
No, but, you know, it's like, there's a 15-year-old kid. Oh, okay. So she goes.
So the dress is where?
I'll grab her towel and kind of walk backwards and hand it to her, trying to not, like...
Oh, no, she has one around her.
Oh, so. Okay.
She goes...
The refresher's where? I mean, your dress is where?
Oh, I can run and grab it for you if you want me to.
No, just direct me, I'll go.
Okay.
All right, so she goes... Well,
I gave it to her while she was in her room, so she would have known it was in her room, because I didn't move it or nothing.
Oh, then she grabs it off the bathroom and then goes back into the room quarters to dress, and you're there with your thoughts.
And I'm going in, now that she's out.
All right. You could describe what you want to do with the party, otherwise we jump forward, you're out of the shower.
Yeah.
She comes out, and you did really well on the dress. You do think that the other shoes you wanted would have been better, but she does actually look the part as Noble's eye candy.
And there was one thing I was going to do, which is probably going to seem strange that he knows how to do this, but, like, using my disguise kit, I was going to do her hair and her makeup. So she didn't exactly look like her. Like, this would already kind of change the way she looks from what she looked before, but kind of do that, too.
Okay. Make an average skullduggery, but add two black, because you're a 15-year-old kid. What the hell do you know about makeup? Okay. Take a strain. You're doing the makeup, and you're starting to become a bit perfectionist at it, and you're like, oh, wait, let me wipe this off, try again, wait. And so, but you worked really hard at it, and...
basically hooking her up.
Everyone that looks at Maya is a bit taken aback of, like, wow, that's a little... That's kind of night and day in how she looks. And then there's a settling of confusion that comes in, because... How did this 15-year-old kid is a makeup artist? You're all set. You go in. She actually seems a little more at ease and a little beaming. Kind of spending time looking in the mirror. You get dressed, and then you're all set up. So Thornton actually says, hey, I'm actually done. And you're like, because you had about an hour left that you planned to.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. We would be going back to where he was doing the credentials and everything.
Yes, yeah, so I haven't rolled those yet.
What? These are the credentials you get the folks on Blue Deck, right?
Yeah, these would be his
My guy can already get on Blue Deck, but it's the credentials.
He's tying credentials to your credentials, because these are going to be the aliens are going to be your servants. So what you're doing, Thornton, is you're actually working a computer program that, you know, if he just says, hey, to get you on Blue Deck, you just would be able to go into kind of the main station frame and slice that, so you can easily say, hey, all these people are authorized to be on blue deck. So there's two things we're doing here. So humans are allowed on blue deck, and you know that if you're non-human, there's a good chance you're going to be stopped by security and questioned why are you there and asked for credentials. So Thornton is working that under your credentials, saying, oh, you're servant of this noble. The second part was you were also going to take all these weaponry to blue deck for selling at a weapon shop, which kind of takes a little level of security. However, Maz, not Pilgrim, Maz actually had Imperial credentials of being a security consultant.
Yeah, Maz,
so
that's
that
what I
you mean. Were tying into that, so you could actually go in there and sell weapons normally. There wouldn't be any like, oh, well, yeah, he's a security. Okay, this makes sense. No problem. That was the main check. Now, if you actually say you have cargo in that particular cargo hold, that is much more difficult to do, and actually you have to get to a station secure terminal, which okay. are all high security areas. So right now I was assuming you were going to go to the basic station where he can go into the normal Lowe's area station tourist guide thing and work that.
I think
everybody else is still on the ship, right?
Yeah. No, Maz came in, gave his credentials to Thornton, and then Thornton said he was done with him. He took it and Maz left. Said, all right, I'm going to the bar. Thornton, I have an idea. Thornton, you know, Colin had a good point of maybe we should do recon. So why don't you just do the credentials for everyone as planned? Some of us will take the weapons and go to blue deck. And while we're there, everyone can kind of do recon in one way or another. Like one of the things, any aliens there might be more friendly disposed to talking to other aliens about gossip and such.
Okay. And I can have Roger assist me with the credentials. He has a group skill in computers.
What would you like me to roll, and how many rolls?
What's the it's computer for credential. It's a 3 purple. There's 1 black from Maya, and then 1 blue from Maz.
Are you counting the blue for the droid helping too, or do I add the blue?
Oh no, add another blue for the droid helping.
Okay, so I'm gonna do the Maz credentials first with 2 blue and 3. Hold on, the purple didn't work.
You didn't roll any purples.
I know, I typed it under the modifier, but it didn't work. And it only gave me 1 blue instead.
So roll 3 purples, a black, and a blue. 2 successive, and a triumph, and a... Okay, take a strain. All this jumping back and forth is messing with your concentration. The droid just goes, remember your breathing exercise, master. In, out, in, out.
Thank you, Roger. He does have patience too, so that's pretty good.
I got your triumph taken care of. So now, after all that discussion, you guys have roughly an hour if you want to take her out on the date and gamble or do whatever you're going to do.
Okay, so she has credentials now?
Not for blue deck.
Okay.
Thornton tells you guys, in an hour, he'll be done, and then he'll have the cards for everyone that needs them.
Thorne would like to propose something to the group, since we have an hour. I recently got some information on how we could make an additional 500 credits on picking up a package that's also located where our frozen and carbonate agent is. So, would someone lend me some money in exchange for which package to grab to take with us when we drop off the carbonite guy?
I already loaned you 25 credits. How much more do you need?
I would like to at least get a book bag and 50 more generic building materials. And the cargo is worth 500.
You want a book bag and and a shopping list of materials?
Yes, about 100 credits. So 150, for about 150 credits, I have information to make you 500.
Well, after giving you that 25, I mean, I can go get you the book bag, but then I don't have any more cash.
I'll give it. So 150?
Yep.
All right. Well, Dell, can you accompany me to go get that stuff?
No problem.
Hey, if y'all take those, where y'all going to? Just out on the space station?
We're going to follow you and then break off from you to do our shopping as you go to the
promenade. Okay, because what I was going to say, the stuff that hasn't been sold, why don't y'all take that to just sell that, and y'all can get that money he needs from selling that stuff.
Tarn just stares at you, going, if you remember me, you handed me two blaster pistols, and Dell and I took a bunch of weapons to the black market to sell, and they only offered us 25%. We'd probably look silly going back there to sell that stuff. That's okay. Why we brought it back to you to sell on the promenade.
Okay, that works. The only problem is, and I start looking through it, the ones that I'm looking for specifically for the ones we took off the Imperial agents, those can't be sold up on Blue Deck.
That's
going to raise too many questions.
You don't see any of those. So Dell and Torn are off to shop, and Torn kind of jokes with Dell about maybe you should form an indentured servitude contract with Thornton for that 150 credits.
I don't like that.
Yeah, you don't hear that. You're on the ship breathing in and out and working a bunch of cards. And this James Bond and his date arrive at the promenade. So make a perception check for me, two purple.
Talk about me?
Colin, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, Tito Buck. Okay. So, I need Tito Buck and Sarad to make me average perception checks, two purple and with one blue.
Sarad has one success with two advantage.
All right, we'll just, that's okay. Don't bother with the purple. So, Sarad's going to have to. So, you see a young nobleman with some arm candy coming into the promenade. And there's something nagging at the back of your head, and you start looking closer, and when you really take and stare, you notice the woman matches the description of the contact you've been trying to meet.
Okay, do I have a code word to indicate that we're supposed to be meeting each other?
No, what you had was a contact number to send out and wait to be contacted back.
Okay, I assume I've sent it at some point.
You guys actually sent it multiple times.
Okay. I would like to... Do I also know that there's a ship-wide alert out on this person? Sorry, a station-wide alert.
Now that you think about it, you know there was a station-wide alert for... yes, there is.
Okay. I would like to walk up to them and suggest that we sit down together for a drink.
Oh, there's my character icon.
Where's my character icon? Do I have one on this map yet? I'll move up to save.
Now, is the promenade Blue Deck, or is that just the place where we was at before playing some?
That's the place you're at before.
Okay.
So you guys should be right at this table, right in the bar. When they come in, actually, I'm going to move you, Colin. You move too quick. They're walking in right here.
Okay, and I spot them?
Yep. And then you kind of tap the Wookiee, and he's kind of looking around, a little confused. Eventually, though, you keep tapping him, and he point, Tito Buck, you actually... It is the woman you're supposed to meet.
Okay. I'd like to walk up to these two and say, I think it would be a good idea if we were to sit down and have a drink.
So you guys are sitting down having a drink. They're moving to the gambling tables.
Yeah, so, I'm wandering over to them and telling them to come have a drink with us.
All right. So, Will.
Colin. Yeah.
Or Colin, you're sitting there. You're going. Maya's seems a little confused. She goes, oh, I guess this is like practice for when we do the mission?
Yeah.
Okay. And then you both notice a Wookiee and it looks like a Mandalorian coming towards you.
Well, I will probably look like a human at the moment. You probably wouldn't be able to tell I'm a Mandalorian.
Okay.
I will have a really big gun over my shoulder, though.
I look at Maya and I look over at the direction where somebody's coming and then look back at her. Friends of yours?
For reference, if you want to know how my character looks, it looks pretty much like this at the moment.
Okay, so he keeps coming up to you.
But I ask her that. I'm like, they friends? I'm like, friends of yours?
She's like,
no, not I don't know.
And he walks right up to you. And you heard him ask you if you would
I think
have
it would be a good idea if we would sit down and have a drink together.
Sure. I'm just killing time anyway.
So, Colin, you actually, as you're approaching the table, you saw this off-duty stormtrooper that looks familiar, and you saw a book on how to excel at POSAC next to him, and he got all excited when you were about to sit down. And then he just looks totally dejected as you continue right on past and go have a drink.
If everyone would like to sit down at the table, I would probably address something to my along lines of, Maya, a mutual friend of ours on Alderaan said that I should be on the lookout for you.
She, you know, she tenses. And,
I don't know what you're talking about.
I'll slide over the contact number on a datapad. I'll slide over the datapad with the contact number and say I've sent several messages.
So, she seems very tense and just kind of looks in her bag. And then you see her kind of look surprised. And then your datapad has incoming call coming.
I'll tap receive on it.
And then the call goes off, and she goes,
what was the name of your contact?
I was sent here by Fulcrum. Said there was a crew that could use my services. I owe him a couple of favors. I also have a friend by the name of Maz.
So she goes,
oh, okay, so you've been sent to help us.
And then looks like Colin.
Nope, okay. So they were the same.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. So
Maz.
So
when he said Maz, though, he would have relaxed on that.
You're as you and Maya are talking and stuff. Both of you kind of notice that the kid is pulling a blaster out, and then you say Maz, and he seems
kind of like hidden under
the
table,
the blaster back in his thing, but it wasn't very subtle.
I'm going to make a comment to him that if you're going to try and draw a blaster on someone, you should be a bit more discreet about it.
Yes, you're probably right. You said a name of someone I know, so we're all good.
I need to do anything else to vouch for my authenticity?
No. I guess they got the message that the mission became harder, but I haven't really said anything.
Well, may I suggest that we don't continue to discuss this here?
Yeah.
Good idea.
Yeah, I know, Colin, did we accomplish what you wanted to do here?
I imagine so, since they were able to recognize you.
She doesn't like you saying that. So you guys are what do you do, Colin? Head back to the ship?
Heading back to the ship.
So, as you're heading back into the ship, you actually see Del and Torin coming to the Turbolifts, too, and Del, what's your brawn?
One?
You see Torin with a backpack full of stuff, and both of them have, like, a bunch of salvage in boxes they're carrying, too. And
I'll hit the button for the turbo lift so they don't have to put that crap down to open it.
So Torin says, hey, Colin, new friends?
Yeah, they, yeah, we'll talk about it when we get away from here. And he just kind of looks around.
Okay. So
once we're in the turbo lift, I'll say they're friends. They know Maz.
Where is Maz?
Last I knew, he went off drinking.
Yeah, you should have seen him in the bar.
He wasn't there.
So how do you know Maz? But and he looks at both of you.
We're from the same house.
I'm sorry, I don't know Mandalorian houses too well. Okay, so did he say when he's coming back?
Fulcrum needed him to go off on another mission. I wasn't given the details.
When you say you're from the same house as Maz, I was under the understanding that he wasn't exactly too active in his house.
No, but we used to play together as children.
Huh.
I'll give you a bit more detail on my interactions once we get out of a place where there may be ears. And I say yes. That looking up at the ceiling of the turbo lift.
Okay. Well, I guess you're going to need to meet the captain. He's also Mandalorian. I don't know how he's going to take this, but okay. And what about your friend here? He doesn't speak much at all.
He just kind of gives a... Tito kind of gives a low growl.
What does he say in the low growl?
Just growling. He's just growling. That's all.
Dorian goes, oh.
To be honest, I still have trouble understanding him.
Well, he doesn't seem to speak.
He is a Wookiee. They have difficulty with basic.
Yeah? Okay. So what's your name?
My name is Sirad.
And then Torin looks at Table Tech, and yours?
He growls his name in Wookiee. Or how do you pronounce it? Shriek or Shriek?
Shriwook. And okay. I'll say everyone calls him Tito.
Yeah, I guess Tito Buck is the closest translation in basic. Well, I'm Torin, and this is Del, and we're not the shoppers or gophers of the group.
Charm.
Del, make me a perception check with one red and two purple.
Okay.
Are we already in the turbo lift?
Yeah, we're heading toward the ship. Del can describe the ship after he makes
a beautiful magnificence. Just can I use a light force point? Because don't like the red one.
I have no problem with it. I'm sorry. Torin has no problem with it.
We got 6 points.
How do those force points actually get used? Is it like say if
okay?
No. What I mean is like if a player rolls 2 force points, can they just kind of use those 2 force points, or can anybody use them?
No. So what the destiny point is? Every force point's counted in the pool. So player and GM works. Players use light side. GM uses dark side. So Dale, the box is getting heavy. But, you know,
I give him to a Wookiee. Since you're here, be useful.
I'm going to step and say, I suggest you don't refer to Tito as a slave. I would suggest that
not slave.
Wookiees can be sensitive about this. I would suggest you ask him if he could carry the box. Rather than make yourself useful. Wookiees have been known to tear people's arms off for insulting them.
I've actually heard the same. Is it okay, Tito Buck?
You lost my...
Tito grabs the box, sticks it under one arm.
Thanks, my
carries
friend.
It for you.
Wookiees are also known to be extremely strong.
That's why I choose him.
So you guys see the ship.
So, well, on the way down, I was like, so what's all this, all these parts for? Are you building something?
That
you could say that.
Yes. That was the request of another of our crew.
Hello. Hi.
That you'll see.
Boy, you are a big fellow. Those parts for me? So, yep, my character comes up like, hey, we got some guests?
Apparently some more people that know Moz that are kind of on the same side of things as Moz.
Oh, good. I'm Thornton, by the way.
Hello, Thornton. My name is Serad. This is Tito. I say,
nice
indicating
to meet you.
To the Wookiee. So what are you building with all this stuff? I'm quite into my gadgets.
I actually have a fascination with droids. As of lately, I'm trying to upgrade some of our gear. So, and the book bag so I can carry my slicing tools and my mechanic tools with the blaster.
Would you like a hand with the construction? I'm a bit of a dab hand at mechanics.
Yeah, that would be great. You want to come to my makeshift workshop?
Sure.
Maya kind of cuts in going, what about the mission?
Look, I was like, yeah, what about the credentials? Did you get those taken care of?
Oh, I almost forgot. Okay, here's your credentials, Colin.
What do you guys need credentials for, anyway?
Torin and Dell, here's what we need, or what you guys need to grab. It's some vintage wine. It's located in the same storage, or same storage closet as the cargo.
Whoa. Please. In the same storage as something we have to pick up. We can speak about this with our new friends.
Maya goes to Dell saying, yeah, they've been cleared for the mission.
What, seriously? More people? It's getting sure.
Torin kind of looks at Dell and kind of nods and nods in agreement.
I'm
not cutting my share.
Although I am worried about the plan to take Maya up there since they were able to recognize her.
Your guys' mission currently? I haven't been filled in on the details.
Could I get an old geyser in carbonite in Blue Deck, the Imperial part of the station, no aliens allowed or their slaves? The Wookiee wouldn't like that. But basically, Organa, Senator, Rebellions, all this stuff. I don't care, I'm just here for the credit.
Out of character question, will my bounty hunter license get me in there?
Actually, come to think of it, yes, it can. And if you have armor with a helmet you could wear, you could probably use the chip they had for Moz.
So I'm going to say at this point, take out my Imperial Bounty Hunter license. Like, guys, I'm registered as an Imperial Bounty Hunter. I think I might be able to help get us in there.
When you say that, I need you to make a perception check. Make a perception check with 2 purple.
I fail hard.
Okay.
Well, that's not looking good.
So am I looking around going, can we go?
Let's do it. Are we going to Blue Deck? All of
us. What's this chip that you were talking about?
So what you saw is when he came in, Thornton said, hey, I got the falsified credentials and handed one to each of them saying, oh, this is for you, this is for you, this is for you. And then he had an extra one and he said, oh, well, this was for the Moz. This was what we were going to use for Moz, so I guess you could use it.
Okay.
He doesn't have anything for you for Tito Buck.
Tito, I'm going to suggest this, although you might not like the idea. Do you want me to take you in as a bounty with a set of handcuffs on you?
He growls really loud.
That probably is not... You could do that. You could do that now. You don't necessarily need to go to Blue Deck to do this.
It's either going as a fake bounty or going as a fake slave. You choose, big one.
So these things, what you're saying is these identifications he made, we've got to go to like the promenade area to at least get them in the system before we go through a security check?
Yeah.
Okay.
13, I'm, give me a computer check.
I might be missing something here. I was trying to figure out what was it that he needed my credentials for, because mine were already good.
We're all tied to you.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Make a computer check, 3 purple, 2 black.
Can I help him on this computer check?
Sure. Do you have skill in computer?
Yes.
Do you have
how many?
Two?
I have 1, so add a blue dice.
Alright, no. Then make it 3 purple, 1 black.
Okay. I would like to use a destiny pull to upgrade one of my computer dice.
Okay.
Oh, it upgraded. My bad. Wrong upgrade. Okay.
That's okay. So, so Thornton, you know, it just so happens that your system's still set up. You could reprogram Moz's chip for Tito Buck rather, you know, within 15, 20 minutes.
Oh, this would be a cinch. I'll go ahead and take care of that for you.
And then you could, tie Sarad to Colin. And everyone's all set.
All right. I'll do that. You want to assist me with this real fast, Sarad?
He basically gave you credits and was like, no, you should probably do that. You should probably do that. It helped your setback. So you guys are all set. Now the question is, who is everyone going to blue deck?
I'm going.
Well, Colin's going.
I thought I was needed to help sell weapons.
Yes. So, Dell, you coming too?
We leave Kelly here so we can fly the ship. I'm coming.
And we can leave Maya here with Roger.
And the droid he put together goes,
Master, no, I can fly the ship too. I have some rudimentary piloting skills.
Yeah.
Would you like me to go?
You help Kadir, huh? You do just as he said. Even if he's going into space, going to a destroyed build ship. So, all set?
As you wish.
So the party comes down. They, you know, when you come up to terminals and stuff, everyone discreetly does a chip. Things work. You go to the turbo lift, and you take it down to blue deck. And when you open, there's a security checkpoint. And Maya and Colin walk through, and they nod.
I don't see things.
You know, Sarad actually comes. Tito Buck comes and he goes, whoa, whoa. There. And then
I look at him and I go, is there a problem?
I need to check his credentials.
Very well, and I hand him my credentials to check as well, since they're all tied to me.
So he starts checking the credentials.
No need, you're fine.
And then he stops and starts taking a look at Maya. Then the thing beeps. He goes, hands it back, saying,
you know you're responsible for what he does, right? So you need to keep him on a tight leash.
Tito gives a low growl. Kind of stares at the dude.
And then he kind of stares at Colin.
He just kind of shrugs and he's like, I got it.
Thornton comes out. His credentials are checked. When Dell comes out, he kind of looks and goes,
they all with you?
Yes.
And then he takes your credentials, checks, pops some stuff.
Thank you, good sir.
Sees him, goes into a terminal and punches things through and saying,
again, just understand. Blue deck, and shops and businesses are up to who they want to serve.
And then he kind of waves you on.
Thanks. And he sticks his credentials back in his pocket.
So you, Dell, make a 2 purple perception check.
You love perception checks?
There's a lot of things happening around you, Del.
Oh, I might want to, I don't want to be considered an a-hole. I'd like to
point. All right. If the party agrees, I'd like to hear that everyone in the party's okay with that.
I'm okay. I'm okay with it.
Yeah, we got more than enough.
Doesn't matter to me.
Okay.
I haven't really had a need to use any of them, so.
Make sure you upgrade the proper die this time.
Yeah, on the left side.
Although I'm probably the one with the best perception in the group.
You were kind of with me.
I thought you was talking about now. It was something for something going on now.
No, this is something else. Okay.
Oh. Okay.
I got a headache trying to remember.
Take two strain from that. So, Del and Thornton, you actually start remembering a day ago. Now, and Colin, you can actually make a perception check of what goes on, like, after this realization. So, go ahead and roll two purple. So, okay. you guys noticed when we were coming off the promenade, you guys were kind of up front, and you remember this guy seems familiar. And you remember him just using his comlink, and then shortly after, he kind of went the opposite direction, and then Maya was being chased by the security guards. So they kind of realize that. What does Del and Thornton do?
Hey, Colin, Del, hey, come over here for a moment.
And then hey. Colin, when he explains that to you, you just realize he just recognized Maya.
We got to probably apprehend that guy discreetly. Yeah. He happened to notice he's wearing the same outfit as the people that were chasing Maya. I remember him being there, but left before the battle started.
Yeah, that's going to be a problem.
We probably need two of y'all to take Maya back to the ship and just hang out and wait for us.
So he starts kind of molding into the crowd.
I'm going after him.
I'm going to try and look for an exit. And try and block at least one exit.
I tell him that, and I'm going towards him in the crowd as well.
I'm going to follow Colin. I don't know what the guy looks like, but Colin might need some backup.
Okay. Everyone do a cold check for initiative.
As I'm going through the crowd, so he don't really recognize that I'm following him, as I kind of weave through people, I'm going to click the button to change the outfit on the holographic outfit to a different outfit.
Okay.
Just nothing specific, just a random outfit that's in there. So that way it'll kind of sort of try to throw him off a little bit that I'm following him.
And what do you want Maya to do? Stand there?
Well, no, before I took off, I told them that two of them probably need to take her back to the ship and we'll get what we got to get done up here.
She goes, I got it. I got it. Maybe I could also help you be a little diversion here. And she starts heading back calmly to the exit point.
Okay.
All right. So Del looks like he goes first. So let's go. It's going to be Del, then it's Colin, then Thornton, and you can recover one strain because you're prepared. All right, then Sarad, then Tito Buck, and then Torin. Okay, so
does he go first?
Pretty close.
No, Del goes first.
Del's the man with that cool. I was like, damn, that's...
Del and Colin go first.
I'll put him after Colin.
Yep, going to move you back, Colin.
Okay.
All right, Del.
Hey, I got the order.
Yep.
And I'm assuming that Stormtrooper is actually there.
Yes, you gotta be discreet.
Being discreet. So far, it's going good for us. Is this guy?
Yes.
Yes.
I'm gonna take out my blaster and put it in.
And I'm like, no, stun. No.
Aw. But keep it light on.
No.
Seriously? Not on that? Ah.
It's up to you. You do know that aliens are not really allowed on here, and there's a stormtrooper right there.
No, I'm just going to follow him and watch out for his next move or anything around, really. Just being prepared, being cool.
Okay, Colin?
Am I able to reach him this turn?
You can do a maneuver and get to him. Do you engage him or just get next to him?
Well, I've been kind of going back and forth on this, and I don't know if it's something that I can use in an RP fashion, because I have a stun cloak, and it says if I get engaged by in melee or brawl, but can I not, like, kind of go up and touch him with the stun cloak myself to use it on him?
Like hug him?
Yeah, you know what? I would actually let you do a brawl check on that.
Okay. Because I'm kind of going to be just like, oh, he passed out, because the stun cloak ain't really going to make no noise like a blaster would.
Okay.
So that's what I was going to try to do.
Okay, so you move to engage. So it's a two, two purple.
Okay.
Okay. I'm sorry. Do one red and one purple.
Skull
Jeff.
Make it disguise what he's doing.
Not yet. I want to see how this check goes. But can you flip? I burned a destiny point, so I think we're back. Can you flip it the other way in terms of the players?
Use dark side. Go.
Yep. Okay. So how discreetly do you want to do this, Colin?
I just kind of want to walk up to him like I'm going to talk to him and put my arm around him, try to touch him, basically.
I would say that's really, really discreet, and so I'll count that as three setback dice.
Okay.
So then it would be one red, one purple, three black.
And how do I use a destiny point on this?
You just need to remember.
Under the destiny point, I just click the little thing that says use light side or what?
Yeah, just click on use light side. And then you need to modify the pool that you're going to roll.
Okay. So you come in to be all buddy-buddy with him. And he says, hey, I don't know you. This stormtrooper looks and starts looking in your direction, and then he strain, and then he five.
You can go ahead and move him where you want. They can't see inside this room until they open the door.
Did you say Sarad's next?
Skig. So that's the guy that you're moving. So now it's Thorne's turn.
Yeah.
Okay, Thorne's going to 1, 2, 3, 4, and uses action to open the door. Sired's turn.
Okay. If this door is open, I should be able to see into this room from my position.
Yes.
Okay, I'd like to start by moving up to him.
So you can engage him using two maneuvers.
Okay, I would like to try something different. I would like to try and use coercion on him, and I'd like to say to him, you need to come with me. I have a bounty on your head, which pays the same dead or alive. If you come with me quietly and don't raise the alarm, then I will not have to kill you. And I'd like to put my hand on my very large blaster rifle, and I would like to use a light side point to upgrade that check.
Okay. Is there a particular stat you're using for him, Jeff?
Yes, I am using private security.
Got it. Okay, so...
And you see that big wiki over there? He's with me.
You're doing coercion. Okay, make a... It's going to be two purple.
Yep.
One blue.
Yep.
Two black.
Yep.
And then do a upgrade on difficulty. And Jeff, can you switch the dice pool?
Do I get a blue? And now I'm using one as well. Is the blue dice for the Wookiee friend, or is that for my big rifle?
It's for your. I'm a bounty hunter, and I have a bounty on you.
Okay.
Can't really see your Wookiee friend.
Well, he's seen the Wookiee though. Okay, any other modifiers to put in?
Nope, so...
So I should end up rolling one blue, two yellow, two black, one red, one purple.
Yep.
It's a fail. If there's no success, it's a fail.
I know.
Okay, could I use the advantage to close the door and force it closed somehow so that he'll have more difficulty opening it?
This door here?
Yeah, the door that I'm standing next to.
I allow you two advantage for you to close the door.
Okay, I close the door.
Okay.
Closing the door.
Who is, I think it's Tito Buck.
Okay, so Tito is going to move over in front of the stormtrooper. Is that him right here by the turbo left, right?
This guy? Yeah.
Yeah. All right, so he's going to move there. Is that in a square?
Yeah.
Okay. He's going to move there and block his line of sight. So he's going to kind of... I don't know if I want to try coercion on him to keep him away or keep him distracted. Is that what I would use on him, or?
You standing there is focusing enough? His attention on you.
Okay.
I'm actually last. Okay. I make sure Maya gets in the elevator and goes off, and I think we should let him go, and I think we should let him go. Worst case, he's going to contact the authorities about Maya, which will help potentially buy us more time down here.
He's going to contact them about Maya and the people with her. So our cover will be blown up.
Just play it cool.
Okay.
Is combat ended then? Is everyone going
to Jeff, disengage? It depends if we're going in combat or not. So... It actually, Del, what are you going to do?
Well, the door just closed, so I can't really go and help.
Okay, I just tell everybody, I'm like, stand down.
Okay, I just go to the stormtrooper and ask him, excuse me, good sir, my master would like to know if there's a place he could buy and sell goods, like food, oil, weapons, maybe? Would you care to show us the way, please?
Roll a force die for me, Del.
Force die?
Yep.
Okay.
And it doesn't work. Playing with two.
Well, you rolled two. I wanted one, but wow.
So I asked for one, it didn't roll.
He actually thinks you're pretty cool. He goes,
Oh yeah, and actually... Do you have a data pad?
Yeah.
He grabs your data pad. He goes, you see him go to like the station system hookup website, and he starts saying,
yeah, so here, there's here, 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 and here. This is yep parts. There's these multiple weapon stores. There's this one gives better prices, but they won't allow your kind there. I don't understand why people seem bigoted. I mean, we're all equal in my eyes, right? Right? Heck. My cousin dated a Ecuadorian in high school, and this other weapon shop you could probably go in. They don't give as good as prices, but you know they aren't as harsh toward non-humans. And if you want here, you go here, 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 and here.
So you're going to get a blue dice on one transaction you personally do on this deck. Assuming you go into a alien-friendly shop.
Okay. Well, thank you, good sir. You're more than helping, really.
If any kind of words you're saying.
If you know the Wookiee, can you kind of ask him to? He's making me nervous.
Oh, don't worry. He's with us. He's with my master. I think he's just looking for the toilets.
Tito just starts laughing.
All right, Colin, what are you going to do?
I go up to the stormtrooper and I'm like, trooper, that man that was just here, were you not informed earlier that the people that were dressed like him were likely rebel scum that has killed and infiltrated those members?
And he goes, all right.
You want to let me call into control.
Do you let him call into control?
Yeah.
Okay. So he calls in,
TK777, calling in from Blue Deck. I'm getting a report from, can I see your credentials, sir?
I pass them to him.
He passes to him and says, your name, Colin, I can't pronounce your Praji?
Yeah.
From Imperial, Novum and Prodigy about there's rebel spies down here dressed like...
And he gives a description, and then there's long silence.
And they say, nope, we haven't heard on anything that, but we'll send more security patrols down to Blue Deck immediately. There's also been a second call of potential rebel activity down there.
He goes,
well, they told me that they didn't get any reports on that, but they're going to increase security around here. Maybe you should think about going back to the promenade.
I have business to conduct here first.
Well, I suggest you hurry.
It's going to be even more complicated. So, more security. One guy we have to take care of, and still no clue about the cargo.
Okay, well, I'll let the group know, hey, just to the south of us is the hangar bay where our cargo is.
Looking around in here, is there any sort of security terminal in this area where we're at?
No, you know a security terminal would be in a security center.
Okay.
So you can go directly to the hangar, or you can go to the shops to conduct business.
Yeah, I can go sell this stuff if y'all want me to.
Yeah, my blue dent isn't worth not as much as your negotiation skills. So you do that. We'll go look about the cargo.
Just don't start any trouble.
You know me. Never.
I'll tag along with colonists. I think my party quests will help make selling easier.
You have to tag along with him to do the selling.
Yeah.
Odell, what was that place you said they'd sell better for?
Yeah, but only for humans. So I give him my data pad and show him the places.
Okay. So Colin's trying to get everybody's attention to come over so we can talk real quick.
Mm-hmm. Was it?
Out of earshot of the stormtrooper and stuff.
Let's go over here.
You don't have to move on the map. Just leave people there. And so you're walking down. You walk a few down toward the shops.
Okay, I get everybody together and I'm like, look. Listen, from my experience of places like this, when the security threat gets heightened, that means a large show of force on the part of the security. Now would be the perfect time to go down to that security room earlier, neutralize those people there, and upload what we need to do in there. And I'll stay here and keep this area. I can stay here and keep this area distracted.
Why don't we just go get the cargo before a whole bunch of stormtroopers come?
We can, but we don't have any documents for it, do we?
You're good at fast talking.
Okay, we can do that.
I'm just
thinking. We may want to hold up on selling this stuff, though.
I would sell the stuff, but the chances of attacking a security station without the rest of the station knowing about it are 733,000,000 to 1.
Never tell me the odds.
Thornton, did you put a droid brain in your head?
I've been hanging around Roger a little too much with those credentials.
I mean, we keep going how we was going. I was just throwing that idea out there.
Okay.
I'm all for going for the cargo. I don't want to spend too much time on the station. We got switches on the loose. Plus, maybe the lung
place. We probably need to get Kadir and them to spool up the ship and get it ready to get over there.
Yeah.
So
after Maya and the Wookiee got back in.
So Tito Buck will pass that message. Thornton, where are you?
I'm where we walked away, out of earshot of stormtroopers.
Del basically told the party, correct me if I'm wrong, Del, but you said, hey, I am going to go down to around the hangar to check it out.
Yep, basically that.
Colin and Sarad are going to sell the weapon.
Okay.
What is Thornton going to do?
I will go with the people selling stuff since they got the credentials that I'm supposed to be there.
Okay. Del, was there any stuff you wanted to sell?
A blaster, I think.
You know the full price of it?
Bathtub store, 400.
I know, Colin, you had two holdout blasters.
I have mine that I'm keeping, but then I had a holdout blaster and a light blaster pistol.
Okay, that's what you gave me. Do you know those cost?
But I'm not holdout blaster is 200.
And a light blaster?
Light blaster, 300.
Thornton, did you have anything you wanted to sell?
No, I keep pretty much everything to dismantle to use for something else.
All right. Now, what store do you go into?
The one that the stormtrooper told him that they would give better prices to humans.
Okay.
I will have to be waiting out.
And
well, they didn't say humans couldn't or non-humans couldn't go in there. It's just they wouldn't really deal with non-humans. So if I do the dealing,
I'll wait outside the shop.
Okay.
I know how big it can be.
Thornton, do a skullduggery check. One purple. So, you guys, do you want strain back? You can.
Oh, actually, I'll give a blue dice to... I'm thinking Colin's going to be doing the negotiation, so I'll give
that
a blue dice.
That is correct. All right.
So, narratively, the shop owner could see that the... character is subservient to Colin's character, and he might approve of the racial superiority of humans, and so be favorably disposed towards Colin.
So, Colin, you come on in. You see, there's like a little security area to go through. It asks to put in credentials. You put in your credentials. Sarad puts in his. So, you guys come in. It is a human shopkeeper. He looks up, tries to seize you. That Chiss with you?
Yeah, he's with me.
You see him just sigh, shake his head. Well, at least he had the manners to not sully my shop.
How can I help you?
I have some things to sell. And he had... who was it that came in with me?
Sarad, the bounty hunter.
And
Torin.
And the stuff he has, the stuff Colin has, he starts putting up on the counter.
As Colin puts it on the counter, Sarad will rattle off the technical specs of them, because he's a gun nut.
Okay.
Mechanically, I'm trying to give Colin a boost die on his next check.
So, as you go through this and lay the stuff out, he goes...
Wow, this isn't the best quality here, you know.
Yeah, but, I mean, it can be repaired and made better. Still good and serviceable.
Well, how much are you looking for it?
And now I need you to make me a negotiation check, okay?
Okay.
You get two purple and one black because you're associated with an outsider. You're going to get plus one blue from Thornton being subservient. Plus one blue because of the credential, Ma's credentials being with you, and plus one blue, so that's plus three total, because you just had another valid individual rattle off all the gun specs.
Okay, and I'm gonna take a strain to downgrade the difficulty of this check by one.
So, and... Jeff, flip another destiny point in favors player, and it's still going to be two purple.
Oh no, this is one of my talents, my specialties.
I'm offsetting your talent with burning a destiny point.
Oh, okay, I got you.
In GM's favor, it's still two purple.
I got you. I got you.
So you have whatever your negotiation skill is. Two purple, one black, three blue.
Okay.
I'm not sure it's success.
Good lord.
That was awesome.
He thinks these are the best blasters ever.
You got the best multiplier you can. So when you guys sell, the people who sell your stuff, you're getting points, you're getting 75% of its value back.
Okay.
As for the triumph, or I mean the advantage, anything you want to burn?
I mean, I'll use two of them to get a strain back. I'm not sure in what ways I can use the other ones in this situation.
One gets you a strain. It's one per strain.
Could we,
okay.
Could we use some of them for him to throw in an item for free?
Oh, yeah, I do need a pair of night vision glasses, goggles, whatever they are, so I can see in the dark.
He can't sell you those. However, he knows a vendor that's close by. He could put in a good word for you.
Okay.
Or what about, does he have the parts I need to make a decent set of armor?
Well, actually, what armor are you looking for? Do you know what type of armor you're looking for?
I'm probably looking for one of the customizable sets for keeping the peace to build.
Yeah, that's what I mean. So you're looking for, like, laminate?
I was probably looking for either customizable armor or combat armor from page 90 of Keeping the Peace. Customizable is 500 credits, rarity 4. Combat is 1,250 credits, rarity 4.
Wow, the armor I want is expensive as hell compared to y'all's.
Do you actually want? Do you actually have the money for that second one?
I don't. I have 300 credits at the moment. I was hoping that the advantage would bring down the cost quite a bit.
You won't be able to get the 1,000 one, Colin. It's your role. There's a chance that the Avenge can cause him to come down in price to help for the armor part. Or you can try to negotiate, get the strain back and negotiate for the goggles.
Oh, I was muted. My bad. I was like, no, I'm gonna go for the armor because my guy is not really much for fighting and he would rather have the ones that can fight be well equipped to fight and build some goodwill with the group. So I'm gonna use it for that armor that he was talking about.
Let's see. You're going to get, so Colin's giving you 3 blue dice.
I'm giving...
Your credentials gives you a blue dice. How many blue dice was in that roll you just did?
3.
So add one more blue dice and roll again.
And I'm going to spend a strain to reduce the difficulty again by one.
Flip a destiny point again for me, Jeff.
Can we flip a destiny point on our side as well?
You can.
Colin, I would like to flip a destiny point.
Go for it.
Okay, so upgrade your check by one then?
Yep.
So, in summary, you're going to have 2 yellows, 1 green, 4 blues, 2 purple, 1 black.
Okay. Yep, that's what I got.
That blows past. Okay, so he's like...
Well... Obviously, you're from an important family, well-respected family, and seems like with the company you're keeping, you're expecting. I'll let it go for 375.
I literally have 300 credits.
Well, how many credits was it that we got from selling this stuff?
You got 200 plus 300. Times 75. You actually, you could trade your holdout blaster and light blaster for the armor parts as an equal trade.
So I'll put 75 out of that back into it so he can be able to get that armor.
I'm loving how we're making all the gadgeteers indentured to us. Okay, so Dell, guess what?
Yeah?
Perception check.
No! Not again. I'm gonna have to spend some XP in that.
This is just a 2 purple check. I think Dell's smart, so I'm assuming... Okay. You take a strain. So... you know, you're kind of sitting there nonchalant. You're doing a good job. Actually, a stormtrooper comes by and waves at you. It may be TK-777, you don't know, but he waves at you as he's walking off. And you're slowly starting to see less and less aliens. Kind of people are thinning out. You see a bit more security personnel coming. But what really grabs your attention is you see a group of stormtroopers with an officer, and they're pushing a repulsor sled. And they go in, they do something with the door lock, and they go into the hangar bay where the potential carbonite dude is.
Okay.
And, you know, figuring that, hey, I should go notify the party, you start walking, and you see them coming down.
Well, I was thinking about using my comm link, but hey, that worked. Guys, we got a problem. Imperials just come by and locked themselves up in the hangar with our cargo and a repulsion tray. They're gonna take the man, I think. We need to act fast.
So you're saying they're about to take our cargo?
Well, I think so. No proof so far, but too big a coincidence.
I radio back to Maz and them on the ship. Hey, did Maya make it back?
When you do that, you notice there's a message for you that says, Red's okay.
Okay.
There's another text going, basically a WTF, why is the Wookiee here and not with you?
I'll say he's there in case the Imperials try and take the ship.
And escorting Maya back to the ship.
I relay that. Did he say it was he said stormtroopers and they were escorted by what?
An officer. An officer, and they had a repulsor sled.
Okay.
I'm going to say to Colin, why don't we just go in and bluff our way in, say that we've been told to transport the prisoner, blah, blah, blah. You play off the fact that you're an Imperial noble and that I'm a bounty hunter under your command, commanded to oversee the transport.
Sounds good to me.
Okay, so folks, you can set up in this area here how you want.
So once we're out of earshot of stormtroopers, if I get to the door console, I can lock it and keep locking it if someone's trying to open it.
I think they already did that.
I think what he's meaning is that we lock it behind us and then cause commotion inside.
Yeah.
And then get the ship to dock and we evac into the ship and blast out of here.
That is exactly what I was saying. Thank you for explaining my techno babble.
It's fine. Some of us need to be able to speak human and techno.
All right, so we can all make our initiative rolls. This is a cool since we're planning this. I guess I have a bad feeling about this. So it looks like Torn's going first.
So this guy goes after Sherrod.
So is this how the party wants to set up going in?
Well, we're initially going in under the pretext of we're supposed to be here, trying to bluff our way through.
Yeah, exactly.
So line up how we're going in.
I'm going in as one of the first people.
Okay, so you go, you punch, and the door raises. Everyone take a maneuver.
So move inside.
You can move four squares.
I'm going to try to move in first, since we're here under the pretext of we're supposed to be here.
And that he would probably then talk to the officer.
And Thornton moves, okay. So you stride in, you're all confident and bluster, and you actually see the carbonite loaded on a repulsor sled. They look like to be finishing up. They kind of look and you go, hey, from one of the stormtroopers, and then the you see the officer turn around saying,
this is a restricted area.
I flip out my credentials. Hey, I need, real quick, out of character, I need some information on that Imperial ship from when we was at that Uncharted Star area, the RZX 1792. What type of ship was that?
An Imperial Raider.
I flip out my credentials and I start talking to the guy, And I'm like, yes, we were tasked to transport this cargo and meet up with the Imperial Raider RZX-1792.
On whose authority?
The Empire.
Emperor's?
Colin, are you here?
He goes,
the Empire? Stop right there.
And he goes,
we got a situation.
And I'm holding my credentials out for him to check them.
Well, you see, he looks very tense.
And so I'm like, on this... Admiral Tarkin's orders.
Okay, now Torn seems extremely tense.
Admiral Tarkin.
Everyone put their hands up. And this stormtrooper hands to this stormtrooper, which hands him the credentials. And he has a data pad. And he starts checking it. Does everyone have their hands up?
Yeah.
I don't. I'm just standing there like, you're wasting my f***ing time. We got to move.
And he says,
once again, put your hands up or you will be detained.
Fine. And I put my hands up.
Sirad will put his hands up as well.
Hey, what happened to the Imperial guy? He's still right there. So he gets his data pad and he's starting to put in credentials. And how is Hell's Prodigy connected to Tarkin?
That's his uncle.
His wife's maiden name is Prodigy.
Okay.
He's Colin's uncle on paper.
He goes, well then.
Are you done wasting my time?
No, the problem here, and he starts beeping up and saying, and you hear him say,
yeah, please send more troopers down here. We have a situation.
He goes,
there is no security access on this. Are you supposed to say the codes verbally?
I just received a message that rebel extremists are possibly here and the cargo needs to be moved now.
Oh, okay.
Everyone can make a perception check.
Who has the highest perception? I will help them look.
Our Thornton can help. I would like Dell to roll though, because him rolling perception is always great.
I'm gonna assist Dell so you get a blue dice.
All right, so everyone, it's a perception with two purple.
Perception with two purple?
Yeah. Well done. All right. So Torin kind of whispers, saying they're getting very, very hostile. And everyone that rolled it success, when he says...
Oh, okay. So you're the support that was sent down to us.
Knows it's total bullshit, and he's trying to stall you now as he pops on his data pad. So, Colin, you could do a free out of order. You could start initiative and warn everybody starting the initiative track, and you yourself can actually get a free four square maneuver before anyone goes. So, Colin, you are engaged with those two stormtroopers, and Sirad, you're engaged with that front one.
Do they have guns or something else?
They have the standard blaster. The officer and the other two stormtroopers are taking cover, so they have a setback die from cover. And then the stormtrooper on that sled seems to have two types of guns trained on the party. That guy, the stormtrooper next to him, and the stormtrooper down here have all taken the cover action earlier in the round. These two stormtroopers have engaged both of you.
So I move there, and I just tell Thornton, I'm like, jam up the door.
All right.
And I'm going to ask Torin to close the door on my signal. I can spend my action to lock it.
Okay.
Shut the door, Torin?
I shut the door. I move here to engage and take a guarded stance and commit a... yep, that's it. I move there, and instead of taking guard stance, I commit a force die.
Next is Sirad.
Okay, how many purple die is this guy away from me?
No more rank. Two. We're doing four short, eight is medium, 16 long, 24 extreme.
But you're also engaged in melee.
He hasn't acted yet, though.
Correct.
Stormtrooper. And he doesn't have a melee weapon drawn, I'm guessing.
Yeah, they are considering threatening.
Okay, so I haven't done much of this game. What are the problems of being engaged with this guy?
So I think you're going to add 2 difficulty to shoot since you're using a rifle.
Could I use a maneuver to get to here so that I'm two purple okay. So I'm 1 purple from him?
So you can use a maneuver to disengage with him not getting a free attack at you.
Right.
All right, you're still there, but you're not considered in melee, and you can shoot at normal penalties. For you to disengage, move there, and shoot, you're going to have to burn 2 strain to do 2 maneuvers. Okay. Or you could do it in 1 swell swoop, but he gets an attack on you.
Are these guys considered a minion group, or is this single stormtrooper by himself?
They're minion groups.
Okay, and this guy, is he in part of that?
No, he's his own separate dude, and the leader's his own separate dude.
Okay, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to use 1 maneuver to disengage. I'm going to burn 2 strain to get an extra maneuver, which I'm going to use to aim at myself at a blue dice. So I'm now shooting 3. So I've got 2 boost dice. I'm going versus 3 purple. I'm going to flip a destiny point to get an upgrade. And I'm going to roll my ranged attack. I've added 1 difficulty to what it would be so that I can have auto fire. Well, I'm only using 1 maneuver to become unengaged.
Okay, so you're unengaged.
And I think I just click this now. So that's only 2 advantage.
However, instead of adding a blue die to a person, you can do a kind of suppression fire on him, where he will get a black die to whoever he shoots.
I'll put a suppression dice on him.
So, army officer. All right, so the army officer is like, resisting arrest! Attack! So he's going to use tactical direction. He's going to perform a maneuver to direct 1 army minion group within medium range. The group may perform an immediate free maneuver or add 1 blue to its next check. So they're going to add 1 blue dice to their check when they act as a group. All right, so that was his maneuver. He's going to take a pot shot at the closest person to him, which would be Colin.
He's firing into melee.
Okay, so I upgrade the difficulty by 1 because I'm firing in melee.
What's your defense is 0?
1.
Oh, you got 1, so I got to roll a black die. So,
and the crit rating on the gun?
3. Oh, it's a crit. And then you would take 7 damage minus your soap. Okay, next person is Colin.
On my turn, I'm going to take cover since he's right there by me. I'm going to get plus 1 purple anyway because I'm engaged, so I'm going to shoot at him, the one right in front of me.
Okay.
All right, hold on. Your short range.
Short range is 1.
2 purple.
And I thought it was 1 purple for short range and 1 purple for being engaged.
Yeah, 2 purple total. So you hit him for 6 points.
And it's Pierce 1.
Oh, you have a Pierce 1. Now that is actually important.
Okay, after Colin is Dell.
Yep. So I'm going to go there and take cover. Take cover and with 2 strain. And I'm shooting on him. So 2 purple?
You're within 1 range of him. So it's 1 purple. Yeah.
Please.
Stormtrooper's turn.
And I also tell Thornton that if you get the door handled before we get these guys handled, start wiping our footprint from the system.
You say that? Do you scream that to Thornton?
I'm saying it through the comms.
I don't have a comm.
Oh, never mind then. I'll wait.
No, it's fine. Okay. What's your defense, Thornton?
I have no defense. Which guy?
This guy. 1, 2, 3. 11 points of damage. Who's after the stormtroopers?
That would be Repulsor Sled.
Okay. I currently have suppressing fire on him for 1 black dice.
Okay. So I'm just going to blast at Dill.
So you need, you have two black dice.
And nope. He's going to give a blue to the, okay, he's going to the Imperial officer. Okay, and now it's Thorne's turn. Ah! So here's the console right here, right?
No, I figure you were already at the console if you don't move.
Yeah, I am at the console. So if I move here, I could have cover from this guy, and I could duck and use these guys as cover and burn two strain. So then I can attack the console to lock the door. Okay, then.
So when you start hacking in, you notice there's a complete system alert on the entire station now. The entire station's starting to go into lockdown mode.
All right.
Good.
So, doing this, how many black dice do I have? If I'm going to
when you burn the two strain and everything, you're at
one
black die.
Okay.
Okay, so I got one success.
Take an extra strain. So you've pretty much locked down the door entrance here.
Okay, so after it's back to Thorne now.
Okay, I guess I take maneuver to draw my weapon, and then I'll take extra maneuver and to do a garden stance, and I'll try to see if I can finish off that trooper from Colin.
Is a guarded stance something anybody can do, or is that like a special ability?
Anyone can do guarded stance.
Oh, okay.
It gives them a black die if you're in melee combat.
Oh, okay.
All right, so this is a melee attack. I need to take off that force die. So that is 5, 6, 7. You are no longer engaged.
Okay.
And who's next after
Cyrad? Your turn.
I would like to use my first maneuver to move within one die of this guy, which I think there works. Is it the same difficulty to hit this guy and this guy and this guy? They're all 15 feet away?
No, so this guy has cover. This guy has cover, and that's firing into melee.
Okay, I will, in that case, just take this guy out. So I have cover from these two then, don't I?
Nope, not until you take the take cover action, which is a maneuver. So if you burn two strain, you'll be in cover.
Right, I'm just going to burn two strain to take a aim maneuver. I'm going to use a light side point to upgrade one of my checks, and I'm then going to fire with non-auto fire against the guy on the repulsor. So that's 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 damage versus that guy.
11, 12, 13, 14.
Yeah.
Okay. And
actually, wait, is he still up? If not, I'd like to keep suppressing fire on him.
Okay. So he's pretty bad, but still up.
Should have had auto fire on. Anyway, I'm going to keep suppressing fire on him then.
Okay, then that's army officer's turn. Alright, so I'm going to use overwhelming fire. As a maneuver, I'm going to direct one of my minion groups within radian range to perform an immediate combat action. So stormtroopers, shoot at someone.
Yes.
Attack them somehow.
Yes, sir. So,
who'd you shoot it at?
Sarad, a grenade hit.
Blast 6.
So it's damage 8 to Sarad, 6 to Dell. Oh, and at 6 to Colin.
Do we get to take away our soak from that?
Yes.
Okay.
And so then, I take 5 damage?
Yep, roll a crit.
Actually, everyone, all 3 of you roll crit.
Well, didn't How did he act? I thought he used the triumph to activate the blast.
No, it's automatically a blast. It's a grenade.
Ouch.
Why do I... Oof, good one. Not alone on this one.
Ouch. They are going to get a... Another stormtrooper is going to get a free attack. Because the grenades are limit ammo 1, so he has no grenades to throw. Actually, this stormtrooper is so inspired by inspired attack. Okay.
Oh, was that on me?
No, that was on Torin.
Okay, and then
so you actually.
So Del, you're 1. Cyrad, you're 2. Colin, you're 3. It worked. Okay, so number 2. Cyrad, you are going to get shot at.
Okay.
So 1 purple shoot. He hits. He's going to give a blue dice to Stormtroopers. Okay, Colin's turn.
Okay, I'm staying in cover for mine, for my maneuver, and for my action, I'm going to use a stim pack.
How many stim packs do you have left?
I have 2. I have 1 now.
1 now, okay.
Are you using it on?
Himself.
And now it's Dale's turn.
Okay, so first,
Who all are injured, because I don't see it marked on any tokens? I know Thornton is, but I don't know what he's at.
Cyrad has been 8 points down in health.
Oh, okay. See, I didn't know.
I'm on 11 and 12.
I'm 8 out of 12 as well. We're heavily wounded.
Yeah, I didn't see it marked. That's why I was just using it on myself. Okay, then yeah, I'll use it on Cyrad then. So I'll just put that my 5 back on me.
Okay, thank you very much.
So use the steam pack, down to 6 wounds, and shoot this guy. Maybe I have him this time.
Don't forget to take a strain.
And he's done for. Please tell me he's dead.
He did. You killed him.
Thanks.
What do you want to do with the two advantage? If you spend 2, you could give any player a blue dice.
I
have
give
an
one.
Fire gun.
Yeah, I give one to him.
Stormtroopers turn. Stormtroopers can't switch blasters to stun to interrogate.
There's only one guy here we want to interrogate. Yeah, that's a good idea. That's a good idea. We're going to do that. So one. So you're. It's only. 1 purple, but you are in cover. Flip a destiny token for me. All right. Yeah, he's going to take a strain. So, Colin, you take 10 strain. 10, 11.
11 minus 4. Okay. Okay.
You still up?
Yeah.
Yeah, just I forgot an incidental. Something really quick. Sorry?
What was your incidental you were going to do?
Take the comlink and shout in it, Kadir, now's the time.
Oh,
if you want to come in,
you're gonna
no
call.
Or never.
Got that. So yeah, you, I'll let you do that. Guess what? Make another perception check, Del. This is a hard one.
Seriously? You monster.
That's fine. Actually, I'm going to do a little house rule here, so... Alright, and then I've already burned 1, so that's the 2 threat. But you... So, actually, Del, you hear... Kadir saying, we're trying! And you kind of hear faintly saying...
You do not have authorization to leave yet. This system's on security lockdown.
Oh.
And then you hear Maya say...
God damn it! I have a backup plan! Give me the comm, and then it goes quiet.
Doesn't sound good.
Okay, so I think I know what she's gonna do. Okay, you can go on with the turn.
So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna drop the prone, crawl under here. So anyone that's not adjacent to me gets 2 black dice.
Alright, so now it's turn three, it's torn.
You see Torin do a wild swing, but he kind of overextended and falls down.
May I suggest that your allies feel that we need to come to your aid, give one boost check to the next player, and then one boost check to me?
Alright, so I give him a blue die, and I need to recover a strain. So you're getting two blue dice to shoot somebody.
Yep, I'm going to go YOLO, aim twice, and attempt to hit this guy who should be one, and this guy who should be one. Am I correct?
Both those guys are one black die, but I think, remember, you need to upgrade your difficulty from your crit.
Okay, so I'm also...
Increase the difficulty of any skill checks by one until the end of the encounter.
I'm going to flip a light side point while I'm at it.
Just give it a second. Oh, we're running out of light side points.
Yep.
And you're shooting the stormtrooper, right?
I'm starting with the officer. I've kicked auto-fire in. I'm going to keep auto-firing into the officer until he's down, and then I'm going to move on to the stormtrooper.
Now, the officer has adversary one. Upgrade the difficulty of all combat checks against his target once.
Okay, right. So you're short. However, you're short range, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
So you should, if this rolls right, you should have one red, one purple.
Okay. There's already a purple there because I'm auto-firing.
Oh, so now, yeah, you're at two red then.
Okay.
Oh, Jesus.
And I'm rolling two yellow and two green and four blue.
Did you spend a destiny point?
Yes.
Oh, nice.
Thank you.
Right. First attack against the officer does 12 damage. Is he still up?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, second hit does another 12. Is he still up?
Oh, no, you got him. Nice job.
Third hit against this guy does 12. Is he up?
Yeah, he's down. He's a minion.
Okay, I end my turn.
Thank you.
What was the other two boosts from?
I haven't taken cover the entire battle. I just screamed YOLO, aim twice.
Oh, you aimed twice. The two dice we gave you. And...
I'm really glad you joined the team today.
Torn goes, Maz never did that. Actually, the captain never did that. So...
Their leader just got killed.
Thornton, Colin, and Dell, you can recover one strain. You don't recover anymore because you're like, wow, this is like the Mandalorians. This is like the stories of the Mandalorian warriors we hear. They're deadly. And then you feel like kind of sense of fear of, oh, yeah, he's on our crew now.
Officer dead. So skip him. Colin's turn.
Okay. Colin is moving up here for his maneuver. For his action, I'm going to do the stim pack on myself. And as an incidental, I'm going to tell Thornton that we need to try to wipe our footprint from being on the space station at all. Try to wipe that data.
Thornton, if okay, Jeff, can I reply for you?
Yes, you can.
Thornton gives you the biggest what the fuck, you stupid technical idiot. Look at you.
No, I'm not technical at all. I'm just trying to wipe our...
I know, but he just gives you, like, you are such an idiot look, but he goes, I don't have enough time to do that. I could potentially...
Can I use an incidental?
Yeah, he could
just drop a logic bomb into their core processes, just try and wipe everything out.
That, he sighs again, as, like, it's a separated system. He could potentially... maybe get the cameras of us entering the bay, but not the station. Definitely not you in the security, because you went to the holding cell and got registered in security.
Okay.
A day ago.
I assume this was one of those security areas that you needed for the special access.
No, this is a general hangar.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so you know
you're in a... if he can wipe us from ever being in here, then that works.
That's going to be so.
I would rather spend my time on something that would help us. We're busted. They know we're on the station. There's not enough time to wipe that from their memory banks.
Okay, who's next?
It's Dell.
If I take 2 strain, can I go in this, go on it, and start shooting?
Let's see. You can go 1, 2, 3, 1 to get on it. Yeah, I'll allow that.
Yeah, well, I'll do that.
So, actually, take 3 strain. Right. Now, there's 2 guns.
There's a net gun and a heavy blaster. Tell me which gun you want to use, and I will roll it for you.
I go for the
I think
blasters.
He wants to use Big Bada Boom.
Big Bada Boom.
Okay, the heavy blaster.
Yeah, this guy.
Medium range. Nice. Only 2 purple.
He has cover. Flip a destiny point.
This guy?
Flip a destiny point. So now it's 1 red, 1 purple, 1 black.
The destiny, I'll upgrade it. I'm rolling now.
So, 1.
Oh. Okay. You missed.
But you got a whole bunch of advantage.
I missed with Tide and I'm shooting everywhere.
What about you blow up this guy's cover?
Yeah, I'm gonna do that. Take what? 3, 4
one,
advantage?
1, 2, 3, 4. I'll let you blow up all his cover for all 5.
5, Cersei?
This isn't a heavy vehicle type weapon. It's just a heavy, kind of a heavy rifle.
I saw the cover. You go and blast him off.
That was Del's turn. Now it's Stormtroopers.
Oh, this is going to suck.
Do they get any negatives for seeing their boss blown to bits?
Yes, and what I'm going to do, even though Colin is the target, something is protecting the group on this attack. So 2 purple. Colin, you're in cover. So let's see. Nice knowing everyone.
Oh, yes! We survived!
All right. Those 2 upgrade, the 2 upgrades worked in your favor. What's going to happen is it does blow up, but everyone's going to have a black dye because it's... Actually, 2 black dye from smoke just showed up.
Biggest range on smoke around here? Is it like 5 foot?
It covers both of them. Both stormtroopers are kind of in smoke. Thornton.
All right. This is difficult. Okay, so I'm going to crawl over here. So I'm going to... Hey, Del. I'm going to assist a Del. So when Del's ready to fire, I'm going to shoot my blaster across from his target so he's focusing on me and not Del shooting at him.
Basically, you're trying to do tactical crossfire.
Yes, now it's Thorne's turn.
Does anyone need immediate medical attention, or can I stick to the failing I'm doing right now?
If you distract him and not make me a target, I should be okay.
Alright, I'll stay in, melee then. I'm just sucking.
Your sword doesn't like you.
Well, but you know what? The flash blinds the other stormtrooper, Del, and you're going to get another blue die. And, I don't know, maybe you can think about using Autofire.
Hey, also, Del.
Oh, yeah, right. It goes on fire.
Hey, Del, since you're on a repulsor sled, you can move 8 squares with 1 movement instead of 4.
Gracious.
Del and Sarad both get a blue die from me. Whose turn is after me? I think it's Sarad.
Sarad, yep.
Okay, I'm 20 feet away, so that's 1 dice isn't 1 purple, isn't it? And 2 black for his smoke.
Do you have any vision things?
Not yet, I'm broke. Give me a while. So I'm getting 2 blue dice from them, I'm taking another 1 to aim. I'm going to use auto fire. I'm not going to use a light side point. Let's see what happens.
Oh, and you don't need it!
Right.
Well, I don't know why you were upgraded. But
to take some stuff off, apparently.
Oh, that's okay. So
can we take it anyways? Can we just count the upgrades as I'm allowed to shoot this guy as well?
Yeah, but you're also critting them, and so you actually wipe them both out.
Yay!
I just open up my best, hold down the trigger, and spray a cone. missing Torin's head by 1 inch on either side of his ears.
Thornton, make a force die roll.
And okay. Can I use a... So, do I have any left to recover strain after doing that?
How much is to activate auto fire?
2.
Yes. You can get 2 more strain back.
Cool. They're both dead. I'm like, right, Del, let's pile all the bodies onto the repulsor lift, pick up the carbonite, dump it in the shuttle.
I already got the cargo.
Oh, yeah.
He's understood.
I want to go just an initial of what people are doing. Okay, Colin, what do you do?
Well, since Thornton walked off, I don't have much computer skills, but I know that if I actually get seen engaging Imperial troops, all of my legitimacy is going to be blown. So I'm trying to figure out if I can wipe the footage from in here.
Yeah, well, you have some computer skill.
And I'm saying that to Thornton as I'm trying to do it, if he can hear me.
Okay. Del, what are you going to do?
I think I'm going to get the sled into right behind the shuttle, so, or in front of it. I don't know where you can where you can go on it.
I'm gonna remind Torin and Del about the 500 credit supply of wine that is inside this closet, clearly marked.
Well, go and take it.
Actually,
I'm busy.
Actually, I wanted to talk to you about that. So you go to remind the wine, and it's actually sitting right here in front of you. It apparently someone else found it and moved it, and you interrupted a potential celebration. So it's actually right in front of you. So you remind us, and what else do you do, Thornton?
Okay, I want to try and lower the threat level of the computer system so it's not as difficult for me to perform slicing maneuvers on.
Okay, you can't do the overall computer system, but you could potentially do this local system. You're at 4 purple right now.
Well, since he's doing that on the computer, and that's what I was doing, I'll give him an assist.
Yes, okay. You'll get 1 blue from Colin, who's like, hey, wipe my record. Wipe my record, please. Please wipe my record.
Can I give a maneuver to assist?
It's not your turn yet.
Okay.
There you go. Lightly good odds.
Okay. So you're going in, you start doing it, and all of a sudden you kind of stop and went, oh, crap. There's like an active hacker. You take a moment to compose yourself, and you're going to kind of think. Luck seems to be with you that day. You're kind of eyeing that brandy and stuff, and you're like, okay, you think you can give it another try, but you got to work it at a different angle. I'll tell you what is, you get the retry, the 4 are gone. Normally, 1 person can assist, but using that 4, you can have 2 people assist, but 1 of the person that assists you has to be trained. So you can get 2 bonus die from assist.
How many turns do I think we've got enough time to loot the bodies after doing the computers and getting out?
Not sure, but you see Torin is picking up 1 stormtrooper, looting 1 and trying to pick up a stormtrooper. You hear on his comm, Maya saying,
evac is coming, evac is coming.
To Torin, I'm going to say, grab the utility belts and weapons and the wine. Grab the armor if you can, but grab the weapons and utility belts first. They'll be lighter per credit.
And Torin seems very overloaded.
As incidental, I tell the group through the comms, get one of the stormtrooper helmets so we can listen in on their comm chatter.
So, okay, so you saw Torin came up and kind of was grabbing, looks like he grabbed something from 1 stormtrooper, and he picked up the other stormtrooper and is encumbered and has it on his back. Someone has told Torin to go get the wine, loot the stormtrooper armor, loot the utility belts, loot the guns, grab a stormtrooper helmet and put it on his head to listen.
Does Torin have a comm link?
I guess you were talking. So Torin had his comm link out and you heard Maya saying, evac coming in.
Not soon. Get ready. Evac coming in now.
Colin went. So Del, This shuttle is not spaceworthy.
Yeah.
But the energy shield's still there, but you can open the blast doors to the hangar if you want.
So the shuttle can't fly, but we can open the thing so that the freighter can land.
Yes. Well, it's sort of. This is the freighter will have to extend a plank out.
I'd like to move here.
This carbon thing doesn't exist. There was only one carbon, and it was on the sled already.
We're gonna
bring it
to the shuttle.
The shuttle's not spaceworthy.
Yeah, but it can protect us long enough so that our ship comes in.
GM, you say the shuttle's not spaceworthy. Does that mean it simply won't hold the atmosphere, or does that mean that it won't move at all?
It looks like some of the engine parts are being retrofitted. There are some blaster holes in it, so you need some spacesuits to fly it. He'll have to go inside and do diagnostic checks to find the full status of it.
What's Cyrad doing then? Is you're assisting me? Are you doing anything with
that? I've dropped all my useful viruses and such into your data pad.
And Colin's assisting you.
So right. Two blue dice.
Okay.
Move the repulsor here for the loot. Because loot over safety, after all.
Alright, so Thorne's going to go. So is it the same purple dice plus blue dice?
As he's starting to do this, folks kind of see a glow on the door.
Turn on all the computers.
Don't think that's how this shit works!
So, that's not very helpful. Okay, so after me, it's Thorne's turn. This is turn 5.
You hear on the comm,
why aren't the blast doors open?
That came from our ship, right? Yeah, that came from
our ship just outside. They're waiting for us to open so we can get in. Get on the sled, we go. forget the stormtroopers, get on the sled, open the doors, and we go out.
Actually, it's Sherrod's turn. Torn grabbed a trooper, then went to the other one and threw him on. So there's two stormtroopers on the repulsor sled.
I'd like to basically lift up either two or three of these people and drop them onto the sled.
Roll me a force die. You can do two of them. Roll me a force die. Roll the force die twice.
I'm starting with the officer and then doing a stormtrooper, so this one will be still here.
Oh, okay.
And if I still have enough, I'd like to sit on the edge of the sled so that I get moved with everyone else.
Not for doing the two bodies. You're stuck where I'm at, too.
Colin. Mm-hmm. It's Colin's turn first.
Oh, Colin.
I'm going to grab that wine and shove it in Thornton's backpack.
Dell, as a backup, maybe you can start using your torch to cut through the blast doors.
Just open the... The controls are right down here near him.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Oh, yeah, that's what I was asking. If there was a control to open it or if it had to go through the computer.
All right, your turn, Dell.
I'll move the sled next to the hangar doors and go open the doors.
So take a 2 strain.
Of course.
The doors open, and you don't see your ship. You actually see a Badu-class freighter in front of you.
I knew that, but still. I open the comment. Maya, I knew you were going to do that, but please, please, for your own safety, tell me if the Grey Star is okay.
Thornton.
All right, I'm going to start making my way towards the force field.
One more. So we currently have all the stormtroopers but one on the sled, don't we?
Yep.
This one get on the ship.
But that it takes an action to go load them, so...
Actually, I didn't take an action. So where's this missing stormtrooper? Right here?
He's right here. He's right here.
So if I'm right here, so I can pick him up and then take 2 strength. There we go. I'm dragging him right here. That's Thorne's turn. Now it's back.
Do a force die roll for me. Okay. Oh, that's everything. So, I'm sorry. All right. At the end of the turn, a ramp lowers down and you see like an R2 unit, but instead of like blue and white, it's green and white. and it starts beeping in binary. Who speaks binary?
I do. It says get on the ship.
Yep.
I didn't need binary for that.
Is it back to me yet?
Are we in combat? Can we just all move?
Do people plan to loot this last stone trooper?
I'm trying to tell somebody, maybe Syrah, that's got one of those big guns. Just computer, let's just blow it up.
Now the question is anyone going to listen to it? Otherwise, we will go out of combat.
Can I make a computer's check to know if destroying the computer would slow them down or do nothing or make matters worse?
You're trained in computers, right? You have
yes.
that one yellow die.
Yes.
You know, he's hacked it. They're burning through. Destroying the computer will do nothing. If he was worried about his records being compromised, well, that's in the system up by now. So I don't know what you want to tell the young kid other than he's...
You're screwed, mate.
We're out of combat, so...
Okay. I'll jump on the sled and pilot it into the ship.
Okay. So everyone gets on the ship. Dell, you get... on your turn, you get a thing of the captain has got the Gracer away from the station. We'll rendezvous outside the system.
Thank you. Get on the sled and put it in the shuttle.
Okay, so you guys jump in. You see actually an attractive woman with white hair screams at you to buckle in and yells at someone to man the gun.
You, Dale.
And then she goes,
someone that knows how to use it, not one of you local yahoos.
Dale. With my pleasure.
Is there more than one gun? I'm also trained in gunnery.
Yeah.
I'll take the other gun.
Okay. Colin, what are you going to do? Actually, never mind. Colin, Thornton, and Torin are huddled up and working on Colin.
I did my heals, but I've still got two criticals on me, so, because I know the stim packs don't get rid of criticals.
Yeah, so, what I need you guys to do is, I need each of you to do a gunnery check on me, it's a one red, one purple check.
Does this now count as a separate encounter?
It's still part of the same encounter.
Two red for me, then.
Jeff, I need you to roll... one yellow, four green dice.
GM, I'm going to take two strain to aim twice.
Okay.
Oh, good idea. I am too.
Okay.
Then.
Am I doing a medicine check?
You are. Colin, do you remember the severity of your criticals and which one do you want to take away first? So it comes down to severity. Is what's the severity level of those crits? One die or two die?
Both of them's two die.
Okay. So it's two purple... Jeff, and then add one blue. Okay, so the ship is flying away. Okay, so your critical's gone, and you get back four strain if you want.
Okay.
There is a Star Destroyer coming towards you, and there are four TIEs coming at you. Dell, you're basically giving kind of suppressing fire to scatter them. There's an auto, kind of an auto fire effect on your gun. You're actually able to take out the TIEs, but then you see your gun overheating and circuits explode on it, so it becomes useless. And Dell, make another gunnery check.
Make gunnery.
Okay, so at that, you hear the captain say on the comm,
"Look. We can't meet at the rendezvous point. We're just going to have to jump to hyperspace, and we'll have to meet you at the emergency point."
And with that, that's going to end the session. So I won't worry. Now, you guys, when the next session starts, because you're jumping in hyperspace and there's travel time, everyone should be recovered of their strain, barring the obligation aspect.
Well,
does anyone else have criticals they need?
I do.
I do.
I still have a critical too.
You're done. I can only heal criticals once per week.
Oh, okay.
Isn't that per character?
Yes, yes. So, are you guys both at two severity or three?
Three.
I'm two.
And who's wounded?
I am 6 points out of 12.
Sirad is 3 points out of 12 wounds.
Okay. So, Jeff, are you there?
Yeah, I was asking you if you... All right, so that check you did, I need you to roll it one more time.
So, two purple with one blue.
Yes. Okay, and then I need you to add a purple and make a roll. Sorry, Dell. Okay, now I need you to make that check with one purple. I'm sorry, Dell. The Chiss hates you really bad.
Yeah, I know
not
that.
True. I held his arm the last time when his almost fell off.
All right, yeah. So you get burn a destiny point. All right, so Dell, you get, unfortunately, your critical's not healed, and you get back 8 wounds.
Oh, thanks.
Now, I need you to make a check with that same check, but make sure there's 2 purple dice. This isn't for Dell. This is on the Mandalorian, which you seem to like.
And yes, oh. Evan of Triumph. Oh, seriously. Jesus.
So what does Triumph do?
I have to read the rules. I actually think I might be able to heal another crit on you, unless you have none.
I have none.
He just really rubs it in Dell's face, I guess. And that's just terrible. So you heal back 3 wounds and 2 strain.
If you hurt Rotons. Roger, you'll have the Mandalorian after you.
Always the Mandos.
Are we able to transfer to our main ship during the travel time?
No. You are in hyperspace going to an unknown destination at this point in time, and we'll pick up at the next game.
Okay.
Didn't we go to the emergency point?
You were trying to, but you had to kind of shake the TIE fires, and you weren't able to, so she that's why she called saying, go to the backup point, I have to jump to hyperspace.
Seeing as we have a pile of Stormtrooper armor, and a toolkit, can we maybe spend some of the time doing crafting stuff?
Nope. We're ending the session. We can pick that up post-session. Okay? Right. So, you will have time. There will be stuff to craft. Now, the last thing I want to get is Torn was actually able to find a complete Stormtrooper, and Sarad was actually able to find a complete Imperial officer. Yeah, so put this in group resources. There is a standard blaster pistol, a data pad, and 150 credits. Okay, that was the Imperial officer. That's all you got from that guy. You basically have a complete suit one suit of Stormtrooper armor, a blaster rifle. This has Imperial stamp on it. You have a vibro knife with an Imperial stamp and a frag grenade. Now, I can't remember who got the other Stormtrooper. You could pick one of those items to salvage.
Suit of armor.
Okay. You got 2 Stormtrooper armor. That was the second one. You got 2 more. Let me go to the next Stormtrooper. So you have 2 full suits of Stormtrooper armor.
Yep.
And then this third guy, you can choose damaged armor, a blaster, a vibroblade, or a frag grenade.
My bet would be armor.
Okay, you're going to put down armor parts. So you get 500 credits worth of armor parts from this. The fourth Stormtrooper is just mangled beyond crap. There is no salvageable parts on this one. You might be able to scrap something by. I need a daunting scrap check. So what was your question, Will?
I want to copy some of these, like the Imperial officer and one of the Stormtroopers, into my holographic costume.
And you can't really do the Imperial officer, but you can't. I mean, you have actually one really pristine suit of armor, and that was the guy Torn kept missing on. And then there's actually a decent thing of armor that, you know, take a couple hours to clean up would be also good.
Okay, so I mean, it doesn't give me any mechanical benefits. It's just so I can look like I'm a Stormtrooper, basically. It's an easy computer check to copy it.
All you need to do is just use a scanner.
All right, okay. What was the salvage roll? 5 dice, 5 purple.
I didn't mean to roll anything.
So you were able to scrap 150 credits. You scrapped 150 credits of universal parts.
Oh, good. Okay.
So the way we're kind of house ruled is there's weapon parts, armor parts, gadget parts, and universal parts. I guess starship parts at a later point.
So you use that credit value in your building, in your building modifying. So we'll pick up coming out of hyperspace where you learn where you jump to, and you also learn what happened with the Grace Star.
How long have we got in hyperspace?
Less than a day, I think. And tell everyone how much XP.
20 experience points.
Nice.
I'm gonna hang up, guys. I gotta go. So
okay.
I'll see you guys in 2 weeks.
Okay. All
right.